What's up, guys? It's MTG Madfew back with another video, and today I know again another ban control deck, but hear me out. This deck is very different from the last one I presented, and you know, I was just experimenting around and I just found a new another way to play ban control, and it's basically my favorite archetype, so I gave it a go, and this deck performed quite okay. I would say it has a win rate between 50 and 60%. In low platinum though, because while I had reached almost diamond with my last ban control deck, I didn't go all the way to diamond, and then through all the experimentation I lost my rank. But anyway, here we are with a deck that I call Go to Zero. Now, why do I call this deck Go to Zero? Because the win condition of this deck is more or less that you mill yourself out completely. You mill your whole deck, and this is more or less how you win. Let me explain. So, we play a banned control deck, and the win condition is the following. We got a single card that's our win condition. It's Awaken the Woods, right? A new card from Brothers War. X green green sorcery, create X 1/1 green forest dryad land creature tokens. So this is just a sorcery that allows you to create as many tokens as you want, just depending on the amount of mana you have available. So you can just make an army of these dryads and then punch your opponent to death with it. But the question is, well, is that a win condition by itself? Because, well, your opponent can remove your dryads and so on and so forth. So, and this is where the rest of the deck comes in. So, hear me out. The whole deck started with the idea that for the first time, I wanted to make Splendid Reclamation work. So Splendid Reclamation, let's actually pull it up in here. Splendid Reclamation is a 4-mana sorcery from one of the Innistrad sets, right? It's a reprint, it's an old card. Return all land cards from your graveyard to the battlefield tapped. And I just wanted to experiment to see if I could make this card work in some way or another, right? And the nice thing is that the Brothers War actually gave us two very nice self-mill cards, right? In 4 copies of Phalagi Archaeologist, that's the first card from the Brothers War, it's new. 2-mana 0/3, a common. When it enters the battlefield, you mill 3 cards. You may put a non-creature, non-land card from among the cards milled its way into your hand if you don't put a 1/1 counter on Phalagi Archaeologist. So this little creature right here is one of the like pillars that holds the deck together, because the cool thing about this card is it mills you for 3, and if you mill a reclamation, you can actually get it back to your hand, right? Because it's the enter the battlefield effect. And hopefully the other 2 cards, at least one of them is also a land. So this card both finds the Splendid Reclamations in our deck and puts land cards into our graveyard. And then the second card we use to mill ourselves is 4 copies of Wasteful Harvest. Another new card from the Brothers War, also common. It's a 3-mana instant mill 5 cards. You may pull a permanent card from among the cards milled this way into your hand. So, as you can see, on turn 2 we can play the Archaeologist. Occasionally he will find the Splendid Reclamation for us. Turn 3 we can go Wasteful Harvest, possibly pick up our 4th land or pick up another Archaeologist. And then ideally on turn 4 we can cast Splendid Reclamation and oftentimes put 4 land cards onto the battlefield. And so already early in the game we have this massive ramp from which we, you know, follow the rest of our game plan. And that's the like the first pillar of this deck, what I was experimenting around with. I was just basically trying to figure out, okay, how can I make Splendid Reclamation work to basically have these huge ramp turns where you go up to 10 from like 4 or 5 lands, you go up to 10 lands or even more. And that was like the first puzzle I had to solve. And it's basically these cards right here, right? We got Archaeologist, Harvest, and Splendid Reclamation. So this is just the package to make Reclamation work. And then the question is basically, okay, what do we do with all this mana and what do we do with all this self-mill? Well, first of all, let's start with something simple. We run four copies of Memory Deluge for our choice of card draw, because the nice thing is, if we mill this card, it's got flashbacks so we can cast it from our graveyard, right? So that's the first obvious piece. Another piece of the puzzle is two copies of Turn the Earth. Turn the Earth is a one green instant that says choose up to three target cards in graveyards. The owners of those cards shuffle them into a library, so you gain two life and get flashback for one on the green. So this allows us to shuffle cards back into a library that we want to redraw, right? And that we might have milled early in the game. And now, as you can see, we got this like core package that, you know, by itself isn't really doing anything. The only thing it's accomplishing is we can utilize the cards that we mill and we put land cards into our graveyard that we can then reanimate, so to say, with Splendid Reclamation. And now the big thing is, okay, so we have a lot of mana, we mill a lot of cards, we put a lot of cards in our graveyard. What do we actually do with this deck? And by the way, one last thing about the mill package. We also run four copies of Broker's Hideout, because the nice thing about Broker's Hideout is it enters the battlefield, it gets sacrificed, we find a land from our deck, right, put it onto the board. But then this in itself puts another land card into the graveyard that we can also reanimate with Splendid Reclamation. And the nice thing is, if you reanimate Broker's Hideout with Reclamation, it also thins out your deck, right? Because you always, you search up your library for a land, basic land card and put it onto the battlefield. So your deck becomes thinner and thinner, and that's what we're trying to accomplish. So Broker's Hideout is also a piece of this self-mill ramp puzzle or package. All right, then lastly, or like next item on the list before we actually come to win condition is how do we survive, right? So we run three copies of Fading Hope for early interaction. Just helps us survive, and very nicely so, we can also bounce back Archaeologist to use it again. Also, Fading Hope in this meta is pretty good because of the Teferi tokens there are, right? This just kills a Teferi token and you get to scry one. Then we run four copies of Sunset Reverie for life gain, putting creatures on the board, cycling, surviving, you know the drill. Three copies of Depopulate as our board wipe. And actually, Sunset Reverie and Depopulate are the only reasons why we run white mana at all, because otherwise this would just be a Simic deck. So this is our removal package. All right, now, so much setup, how do we win? So the idea of this deck is, we mill our deck out completely, so we have zero cards in hand, right? And we got a ton of mana very fast due to Splendid Reclamation. Now, we use this tons of mana to cast a single copy of One with the Multiverse. One with the Multiverse allows us to cast spells from the top of our library. And once per turn, we can cast a spell for free, but that's actually not that important for this deck. So we got our One with the Multiverse, out on the board. And there are no cards in our deck. Now, the idea of this deck is we cast a huge Awakening Woods, so we build a board of like, let's say, 12 Dryads, right? So we've got 12 Dryads on the board, your opponent has something on the board, it doesn't matter at all, right? And then, on your opponent's turn, we cast our single copy of Hercule's Final Meditation. This is a card that I had already highlighted in an earlier video of mine. So it's a 7 mana spell, but on your opponent's turn it costs 3 more to cast, so 10 mana in total, but this doesn't matter, because with this deck we easily have 20 or 22 mana available towards the end of the game. And the spell says return all non-land permanents to their owner's hands, end the turn. So what it does, first of all, it ends the turn, which means you kind of time walk your opponent, right? Your opponent has to end the turn. But more importantly, it returns all non-permanents back to the owner's hands, which means the board is going to be empty for our Dryads to just attack for the win. And our Dryads are not returned to hand because they are lands, right? They're token land creature tokens, so they are not affected by Hercule's Final Meditation. So then you got the situation, okay, we got a board of Dryads, we have bounced everything our opponent has on the board. And remember, we got zero cards in our deck, right? So Now what we can do is we use our turn the earth to shuffle back into the library our devious cover-ups or our wake in the woods if we need it again, right? And from the top of our library we can just infinitely counter everything our opponent plays. And also devious cover-up shuffles back the turn the earth, so then the turn the earth can shuffle back the devious cover-up. And you know, like with one with the multiverse, turn the earth and devious cover-up, you basically created this prison for your opponent that he can't escape from, because you will always have enough mana to cast all of the counter spells you need. And that's the whole idea. It's it's just another pretty toxic deck, and it's surprisingly consistent. As I said, full disclaimer, I just tested this deck in Platinum, but you know, I had a plus 50% win rate, so in theory you can climb with this deck, and it's surprisingly consistent. You surprisingly often reach the bottom of your deck and then you just go for it, right? And obviously this deck has a huge downside, which is if your opponent somehow manages to exile your only copy of Awaken the Woods, you just lose, right? Well, actually theoretically you don't lose, because you can infinitely shuffle cards back into your library and infinitely counter spells. So I guess the opponent could deck himself out, but then the game goes on for like 40 minutes probably. But yeah, Graveyard Hate is the big enemy of this deck, but there isn't too much Graveyard Hate in the meta right now. Anyway, I talked enough. Hope you guys enjoy today's video, and I see you guys soon. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone who harms my people must contend with me. Your blade strike true. Protect the people.